Hello, friends. My name is Alyssa, and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum. And today, as part of Earth Month, we are going to learn about pollinators, those special animals that help bring flowers and fruit to life. And then, we're going to learn about how you can help them. Maybe you just think of pollen as the stuff that makes you sneeze, or that turns everything kind of yellow in the spring and in the fall. But pollen is what lets flowers make new flowers and fruit. Without pollen, we wouldn't have apple flowers to make more apples. Have you ever been apple picking? And we wouldn't have cherry flowers to make cherries. I love cherries. Without pollen, we wouldn't have lots of the foods that we love to eat. In order to make more flowers, pollen needs to travel from one flower to another. The wind can help with that, but mostly it's certain animals, like bees. Look at this bee getting the nectar out of the flower, and she's getting covered in pollen while she does it. So the next time she goes to another flower, she'll bring the pollen with her. Hummingbirds also help to pollinate flowers. And in some parts of the world, bats come out at night and look for nectar and move pollen from one plant to another. And butterflies do the same thing. So it's really important that we have these animals to help pollinate the flowers so we can have more flowers and more fruit. Even the bees are really important. You can help pollinators by planting the kinds of flowers that they like. Or, if you don't have a place to plant flowers, you can put out feeders. Making a butterfly feeder doesn't necessarily help move pollen from this flower to this flower. But sometimes this flower and this flower are really far apart, and the butterflies will need something to eat in between so they have energy to keep going. That's what our butterfly feeder will do. Here's the things you'll need. You'll need a jar. It can be big, it can be small, it can be in between, it doesn't really matter. As long as it has a lid. You'll need a clean, new sponge, a pair of scissors, some heavy twine or string, something like that, water, sugar, a hammer and a nail, and a piece of wood, or something that you can hammer into that won't get damaged. Measure out 9 parts water to 1 part sugar. Depending on the size of your jar, that could mean 9 teaspoons of water and 1 teaspoon of sugar, or if you have a giant jar, 9 cups of water and 1 cup of sugar. Stir your water and sugar together into a bowl. With grown-up help, bring your sugar solution to a boil. Then, let it cool.
While your sugar water is cooling, you can decorate your jar if you want to. Butterflies are attracted to bright colors, so if you decorate your jar, it might help bring the butterflies in. There are lots of ways you can do that, so I'm not going to get into that today. Just Google how to decorate a glass jar, and you'll find lots of ideas. You can paint, you can wrap it in yarn or washi tape, you can collage something onto it. You can do whatever you want. Just whatever you do, make sure that it's waterproof. And don't add color to the sugar water. That seems like an easy way to add color to your butterfly feeder, but the food coloring is not good for butterflies. So if you want to add color, do it on the outside of the jar.
Have a grown-up help you punch a hole in the lid of the jar using the hammer and nail. Cut a small strip off the edge of your clean sponge. Feed the strip of the sponge through the hole that you punched into the lid of the jar. This can be a little tricky. You may need to cut the sponge down a little smaller or repunch the hole in the lid so it's a little bigger. I found that it actually worked a little better if I got the sponge piece a little wet. Then get a grown-up to help you figure out the best way to tie the twine onto the jar so that you can hang the jar up. And remember, you want the jar to hang with the lid side pointing down.
Well, my jar is decorated and ready to hang. I've got my feeder part ready to go. So I guess now all I have to do is put the food in, take it outside and hang it up. Put that on nice and tight. All right. Let's go hang it up and see if I get any butterflies. Well, there it is. I hope I get some butterflies and they'll help spread the pollen through the flowers in my yard and around my neighborhood. I hope you enjoyed learning about pollinators and making a butterfly feeder today. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to follow us on social media and subscribe to us on YouTube. Just click the big red button. Thanks for joining me today, and I hope I'll see you next time.